Welcome to the Walter Scott Jr. College of Engineering at Colorado State University.
This building is called the Walter Scott Jr. Bioengineering Building. We have classrooms, study and meeting spaces, graduate and teaching labs, and the Engineering Success Center.
CSU has a strong relationship with Lockheed Martin, who donated these design studios to our engineering program. These spaces are modeled directly from Lockheed Martin's facilities and promote working in a team. Wherever there are computers, there's printers. Printing credits are provided with your student fees.
In our chemical and biological engineering lab, you will practice applying the engineering concepts learned in the classroom. A few of the topics covered in this lab include oxygen transfer, membrane separation processes, heat and mass transfer, and bacterial growth. Many of these experiments will use equipment such as centrifuges, bioreactors, and spectrophotometers. In this video, fourth year students are extracting samples of protein that was grown by E. coli in a bioreactor. They're using a spectrophotometer to measure the absorbance of these samples in order to detect the presence of the proteins and quantify their concentration. Through this field of study, you can work for a broad spectrum of industries that work to find solutions to health and environmental issues. Many students go on to work in pharmaceuticals, oil and gas, food, biotechnology, and renewable energy.
The Biomedical Engineering Teaching Lab is one of the most anticipated classes in the biomedical engineering curriculum. In this class, biomedical engineering students from all three of the partner majors, mechanical, electrical, and chemical and biological, come together to solve modern problems in the healthcare industry. This class is known for teaching our students how to be true engineers from start to finish. Students learn how to conduct research, identify new solutions, back their ideas with experiments, and confidently present their solution.
Welcome to the Scott Bioengineering Atrium. This is a great place to study because the building is always filled with natural light. You can also see many tables on your right for students to study and glass panels to use as whiteboards. Labs are on your left. The first floor and third floor of this building are used for research. Please consider getting involved in research by reaching out to professors at CSU. You can also now see in the distance the Judson M. Harper Auditorium, also known as Scott 101. I attended my first biomedical engineering class in this room with a size of around 100 students. The largest class size that I have experienced is around 250 students in Gen Chem 1 my freshman year. I like to sit in the front of classes to ensure that I'm paying attention and make the class feel smaller. This is a wonderful westward view of campus while standing near the Laurie Student Center. The rec center is on the right.
So welcome to the older building of the College of Engineering. This building really focuses on the older and established engineering majors such as civil and environmental engineering, mechanical engineering, and electrical and computer engineering. One of the first projects that I really like to talk about is actually electrical and computer engineering open option projects. So these projects are specifically catered towards first, second, and third year students, but this project has really helped to design or is really designed to help supplement students in their learning.
This is the Civil Engineering Materials Lab, better known as SMASH Lab. And in this class, you'll learn about common civil engineering materials such as concrete, steel, and wood, and get to smash, stretch, and twist them to see what it takes for them to break.
So welcome to the Education Manufacturing Center, or EMEC. This is the lab that students will take in their second year of the mechanical engineering curriculum. This is a really awesome lab because it's as hands-on as you can get. In this entire semester, students will only work on three projects, but that's because they'll oversee the entire extent of making an object. So from the blueprints and the design all the way to the finishing touches, students will work with heat treating and lathes and mills and even woodwork to make finished products such as a clock or a screwdriver. This lab really looks at how accurate and precise your products can be once they're finished. Most products are graded on some thousandth of an inch of accuracy, so it needs to be really, really accurate to be able to fit all the pieces together correctly and to be able to function as it should.
So this is a lab called the Thermofluids Lab that mechanical and civil and environmental engineers take. And so in this class, the way that this works is that it will be accompanied with a class as all of your labs are. And so in this class, you're seeing how different types of elements like heat and water and air and wind move within the different systems that we have here for you.
So welcome to the Idea to Product Lab. This is a 3D printing lab available to all students in the College of Engineering, and it's located in the Mechanical Engineering Wing.
Let's take a peek into the Internet Cafe. Now, despite cafe being part of the title, they unfortunately do not serve coffee here, which is a bummer for me because as a college student, that's probably the largest part of my diet, but it is a great study space and offers a great view of the Fluids Lab, which you saw a sneak peek of earlier. Now, this was definitely one of my most challenging courses because it involved a lot of hands-on learning, critical thinking, technical writing, and collaboration with my peers. But it does go to show that engineers are responsible for some pretty hefty projects, and it's important for your degree program to be challenging so that you can be fully prepared to be a competent engineer when you graduate and go into industry. Now, just taking a quick peek at the study space itself, students often come here in between class to print assignments or utilize the computers, which include all the software you'll need for any class, including Microsoft applications, CAD software, modeling, or coding programs. And this space also offers a great view of the Civil Engineering Materials Lab. Hanging from the ceiling there, you'll see a canoe made by the CSU Concrete Canoe Team, which is a senior design project. Engineering is a very tight-knit community at CSU, and if you're struggling with an assignment, it's likely that you can find somebody in this space that's working on the same thing that you are and be more than willing to help you.
Thank you so much for joining us on a short tour of our engineering buildings here at Colorado State University. If you have any questions or would like to talk directly to one of our student ambassadors, please email us at explore@engr.colostate.edu. Thank you so much, and go Rams!